Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. My name is Kenita Honesty, aka Your Honest Agent. This video is going to be a review video of another YouTube video that's talking about, and I have the title, give me one second. It is called Harrisburg, PA, Top 10 Reasons You Should Move Here. So I actually came upon this video a couple of weeks ago and I started off, you know, I watched a couple of minutes and then I said, you know what, I need to pause this and I need to record myself watching this video. So that's what this video is about. I'm curious to see what he has to say. So let's get to it. So I'm pretty excited to just jump into this video, the top reasons why you should move to Harrisburg, PA. So let's do it.
Hey everyone, welcome to 601 Travels. Today we're going to the Keystone State in the capital city, none other than Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. With just about 50,000 people that call it home, it sits right here on the map, way over here in the northeast corner. Beautifully situated on the banks of the Susquehanna River and with a grand state capitol building,
nice.
Harrisburg offers picturesque views and miles of riverfront walking for outdoor activities.
You can't tell me that's not beautiful.
It is also conveniently located with quick access to places like Baltimore, Philadelphia, and to our nation's capital.
Yeah.
So I know what you're thinking. There's so much to do, and Harrisburg sounds like such a great place. What could possibly be so bad? Well, I'm glad you asked. So stay tuned as I tell you the top 10 reasons you should not move to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania. Number 10, toll roads. Before you tell me in the comments section, please understand that I do know not every road is a toll road, but if you're from Harrisburg or have ever driven through there, then you will understand how if you want to get anywhere, you will probably end up taking a toll road. I-76 will take you east toward Philadelphia or west toward Pittsburgh. It's also pretty expensive, about $60 if you drive it statewide. It will
Okay, so, first comment, I have only ever used the turnpike when I go to Philadelphia or when I go to Pittsburgh. And honestly, that's probably maybe once or twice a year, if that. I don't use the toll road, aka Pennsylvania Turnpike. Yeah, there's honestly no need for it. You can get anywhere you need to using 83 or 81. I mean, I do know of some people who have an easy pass to use, you know, the turnpike, but that's because they are constantly traveling, so interesting.
Also add up, especially if you need to use it multiple times per day to commute, which more than likely you will have to.
False.
Number 9, Amish people. Amish people are freaking awesome. They're genuinely pretty friendly, make awesome quilts, and really good candy. You can find a lot of them throughout the area on horse and buggy, or riding their scooters down back roads. And if you are careful, you can wind up hitting them pretty easily too. It's actually happened a lot in the past. Not by me, by other people. So please, look both ways when you're driving. Some facts about the Amish people are that kids aren't allowed to go past the 8th grade. They can't pose for pictures because it steals a part of their soul. They have their own language. They are obsessed with slow pitch softball, and they sometimes marry their siblings. That's another video.
Okay. So, yeah, Harrisburg? Sorry, there are no Amish people just riding scooters or on their horse and buggy. Sorry. That's not what you see here. Maybe in different counties, Lancaster primarily, but Harrisburg? Sorry. False.
Number 8. 1979 and Three Mile Island was set to melt down. A nuclear plant on a sandbar in the middle of the Susquehanna River, just south of Harrisburg. Well, it didn't get that bad. They said the radiation levels were emitted to residents were low, but almost did, and it scared the shit out of everyone in Harrisburg. Today, the reactor is sealed and full of radioactive materials and isn't set to be dismantled until 2041. The main reactor was just decommissioned this past year, and now we are left with a radioactive island that is a problem just waiting to happen. Not exactly good for resale of your real estate or living in Harrisburg. It's something...
Okay. So, in dealing with real estate, when it comes down to Three Mile Isle, honestly, people aren't too concerned with it. I mean, it's decommissioned. It's no longer in use. And if anything were to happen, it'd be way more than just this area being affected, just to put that lightly. And this this nuclear plant, okay, yes, it's not in Harrisburg. It's actually in Middletown. But yeah, people were freaked out when there was an issue in the 70s, but you know, all was taken care of, and honestly, there's no thought about it. So
everyone knows about, but just kind of overlooks.
Stop! Did you know every time you shop on Amazon, you're helping someone make passive income? Yes, you could be helping.
Number 7, snow and ice. Harrisburg gets an average of over 2 feet of snow per year. That's over 24 inches for those of you playing along at home. Add hills and mountains to the mix, and you've got a hazardous driving condition. PennDOT doesn't exactly act very quickly about plowing and sanding their roads either. Often you will be driving the tracks of other cars and trucks just to get to where you're going, because you have to. They don't take into consideration people who have to get up and go to work, as most have a commute and rely on the highways to be clear. But they're not.
Okay. So, I actually worked for PennDOT for 9.5 years, and they pride themselves in being able to get out on the roads and making sure that they are safe. One of the big disasters that we had here in PA, it was on Valentine's Day. I want to say it was probably 2006, and they call it the Valentine's Day Massacre. It was pretty bad. You know, they didn't anticipate the storm being as bad as it was, but because of that storm, they made sure that they are always on top of things. So at least here in my vicinity, South Central PA, most of the times, you know, the roads are pretty good. You know, if you live on a back road that, you know, not many people travel on, then that may be a little different, and that I'm sure is for, you know, any state that has snow. You know, but as far as like huge amounts of snow, because we are in the valley, it is a little different here. You know, we get a little bit more ice, I would say, than anything. But honestly, it's not that bad here. It gets cold, but PennDOT usually takes care of their roads. If I'm wrong, let me know. But maybe I'm biased because I worked for PennDOT for 9.5 years. But let me know if I'm wrong. Next.
Number 6, homeless people. Now, I genuinely feel bad saying that you shouldn't move to a city because of homeless people, because it's not like they're all bad. I believe everyone has a story, and a lot of them are good people who fell on bad times, hard times, and just need help. With that being said, there are a lot of aggressive and troubled homeless people out there too, and that is what I've encountered in Harrisburg. The ones that kind of get mad if you don't give them money while you're at a stoplight, and they throw shit. Or the kind that take your $20 right to the liquor store and drink away their problems.
Wow. So I've lived in this area for a good 15 years. And as far as the homeless population, honestly, there's going to be homeless in every city. But here, there's not a lot. I don't usually see a lot of homeless people on the streets. I mean, if they are, they're just minding their own business, you know, like they usually are in any city. And it's, I've never been in a vicinity of an aggressive homeless person. And, you know, to say that homeless people will take $20 and go to the liquor store, I have no words. Next.
If you end up in a bad part of town where there are homeless people, chances are they will stay to themselves and not bother you. But just be ready if you have to react, because unfortunately that's just the world that we live in. Number 5, crime. 1 in 27. Those are your odds of being a victim of a violent crime in Harrisburg. That's for and all those other things I have to bleep out because YouTube will censor the video otherwise. With one of the highest crime rates in America, it is a very dangerous city to be in. While areas downtown and close to the Capitol building can be safe to walk around, and very pretty, if I might add, the landscape changes quickly once you start to wander down side streets and outlying areas. They are definitely the kind of places you keep your windows up and your doors locked while you are driving through.
Okay, so I'm sorry, but if I'm driving in any city, even a rural town, I'm locking my doors. Doesn't matter. And Harrisburg, as far as crime, like I mentioned in my first video, coming from the suburbs of Washington, D.C., you know, there's a lot of crime out there, a lot. And here in Harrisburg, I'm sorry, there's no comparison. Maybe because of the population, I can understand that, but honestly, I don't feel threatened walking down the streets of Harrisburg. I really don't. Wow. Like I said, I didn't get this far in the video, so I'm just kind of, that's just unsettling, because that, false.
You know, the kind of streets where there are rows of row houses that are vacant and vandalized with graffiti and used as a trap house for drug addicts. Those are the kinds of streets you don't want to end up on, and they are everywhere in Harrisburg.
No, they're not.
Number 4, flooding. Okay, so if you build a city on the river, you have to expect flooding, right? Well, Harrisburg sits right on the banks of the Susquehanna River, as I mentioned, and when she gets full, she overflows. It is a beautiful sight when it's below flood stages, but you get that worked up and you're in troubles. There are a lot of neighborhoods and communities directly up against the river that are under constant danger of flooding. Many are low income. Since the late 1700s, when they started recording the flooding, there have been over 45 floods in the city of all stages. To be safe, make sure that you have a...
Okay, so a little bit of history about Harrisburg. So, the closer to the river you are, the more expensive the houses are. So, back in the day when, you know, there were, you know, building up Harrisburg, that's where the rich people lived. And that's why they have detached garage, because most of those garage or, you know, extra living space, we'll say, were used for horse stables. That's where they kept their horses. And as you get closer into the center of the city, that's when, you know, the homes are a little bit smaller. They're not, you know, as higher value as the ones that are closer to the river. So as far as saying, you know, a lot of, you know, low income properties flood, you know, I would say a lot of homes right on the river that aren't low income, but are very, you know, nice businesses, you know, beautiful Victorians, they flood too. There's an area actually called Shypoke. And they actually have a lot of flooding there too, and those homes are beautiful there. Beautiful view of the river. So you know, wherever the flood zone is, that's where it's going to flood. So it doesn't matter if you're low income or if you have a lot of money. It doesn't matter. It's going to flood. So, next.
Inflatable rafts and floaties and evacuate if you can. The state capitol steps are tall and above flood stage if you need to take refuge. Number 3. There's nothing there. Harrisburg is a boring, nothing-to-do city unless you like farm shows at the farm show complex. Those are kind of cool, but how many times can you see two cows find it funny? I lost count at around probably 18. The complex does host a few neat events like...
Okay, so I'm not a fan of the farm show just because I don't like... I don't know, it's just not me. It's just not something I like. However, my little one loves it, so I do take him every year because that's what he wants to do. But as far as there not being nothing to do, I mean, there's a lot of things to do. You know, you just got to find it. You know, Harrisburg is about enjoying nature. You know, this whole area is about enjoying nature. So go out for a hike. You know, go out for a picnic. You know, find a nice, you know, lake somewhere. There's a lot of things to do where it doesn't involve, like, I don't know, like, huge city entertainments. Like, I don't know, I can't think of any examples right now. Maybe clubs or something. There are clubs here, but nothing extravagant. But, you know, there's a lot of things to do. It's more family-oriented here, you know. So expect to do things with families, you know, festivals and parades and things like that. Like,
the auto show and the home show, but I'm referring to entertainment events. They may have a few parks, but there's nothing downtown or in the city aside from the state jobs and other retail spaces. If you want any kind of real entertainment, you will have to go out of the city to places like Hershey, where they have a huge venue for concerts and an amusement park.
Okay, it's Hershey Park. It's Hershey Park.
City Park is close to Harrisburg, but it doesn't have year-round attractions. Other places like Philadelphia and Baltimore are close by for entertainment events like concerts and sports.
Yes.
I wouldn't recommend moving to those cities either, for other reasons, but at least there you can have fun while dodging bullets and... Number 2, street racing. I'm not going to name names here, but someone with a name that rhymes with beat, lead, heaven, ton, heaven, wait, that doesn't even make sense. Beat, lead, heaven, ton, heaven, that's it, likes to drive his Corvette on the streets of quote-unquote Mexico at high rates of speed, demonstrating what American muscle can do. This person is very popular in the Harrisburg, Pennsylvania area, and his YouTube channel has over 1 million subscribers. He also ignores my fangirl style emails, and that's okay, because I know he's very busy. There are no...
Okay, so I don't have a comment on that. So I don't know who he's talking about, or street racing. I don't know anything about it. Never seen it. I don't know what he's talking about, so... I guess I'll have to do some research on that and update this video, but if anyone knows who he's talking about, please let me know.
Hard feelings. Shoot me an email sometime, bro. Number 1. Home prices. No, not that the home prices are expensive there. Yes, there are some exclusive neighborhoods, but when you can buy a house for $10,000 to $20,000, or an entire city block for, you know, like $100,000, you know that things aren't right. Most, if not all, of these houses are condemned or in such a state of disrepair that there's no point even trying to rebuild them. Even if you do, all of your neighbors will be vacant drug houses used for illegal activities, like addiction, things like that. Pennsylvania is notorious for its rundown row houses and tax delinquent properties. They're empty and sitting vacant for a reason. Don't be a sucker and buy one cheap thinking you got a good deal. Because while you're unloading in new appliances during the day, someone will be stealing them at night.
So, as a realtor, that's just crazy information. There are a lot of investors that invest in the city. They rehab these properties, and these properties are awesome, you know. And I'm not going to say that there aren't, you know, slumlords, because there are. And I'm not going to say that there aren't absentee owners, because there are. But the problem is, a lot of these absentee owners live out of the state, you know, and it's hard to find these people, you know. So they just, what can you do with these buildings when you have people that don't even live in the state that own these properties that don't take care of them, you know? So that is a huge, situation in Harrisburg. However, it's not as bad as he's making it seem to be. There are some beautiful areas in Harrisburg, absolutely beautiful, and this video is not giving Harrisburg justice. I'm sorry. You know, I've been here for 15 years, and Harrisburg has definitely grown on me. You know, the older I get, the more I appreciate it, because it is teaching me, you know, to kind of calm down. You know, not everything has to be a rush, but I'm speechless with this video. I'm absolutely speechless.
Alright everybody,
where's
that will be it for today's video on the top 10 reasons you should not move to Harrisburg, Pennsylvania.
So, after watching that video, I don't even know what to say. I'm lost without words. It honestly, it seems to me like this guy just happened to come here, I don't know, for a couple of hours, and he drew his opinion based off of that. There are a lot of good people here in Harrisburg, and most of the people here have pride in their city. They love their city, and it's not fair for him to put a video out there like that and not really understand or even live here to post a video like that. That's like me posting a video about, I don't know, Denver, Colorado. And I've never been there at all. And that's how I feel this video, that's how I feel it represents this guy. And that's not fair. Wow. So I'm glad I got that off my chest. I knew it was going to be an interesting video, but that was pretty disappointing. So whoever you are, 601 Travels guy, whoever you are, please reach out to me. I'd love to show you around the city. You know, take you to some places, try some food, you know, and really enjoy yourself, because you should redo this video. Honestly, you really should. But anyway, if you like my video, please like it. Don't forget to subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Peace and love.